I think this probably has come up, will come up. Experienced traders worry about slippage.
Oh.
So how does OmniFunds address this?
Oh yeah. It's a good one. In fact, you remind me of something that we recently did that's really, really awesome related to this. So we only trade really liquid stuff. So Nvidia, Tesla, you know, stocks like that. And honestly, I talked to a customer the other day. I was doing an interview, and this guy's trading, like, I couldn't believe it when he told me this, but like a million shares. He was doing Intel. And so, I mean, these markets are so liquid. You really can't have a problem with that. I mean, a big trade, it's unlikely. There's so many millions of shares being traded, like almost on the second, so that our trading at this point is just not going to affect it. Now, at some point, you know, we get 5,000 users on this thing, then it could. So what we're doing is we're watching those executions, and you can see them. There's a report in when you come on and you hook up to your account, there's a little report you can see that shows every execution that you had compared to what it could have been. Like, if you got the perfect price in the market where it took the trade, which I'll explain in a second, you know, how did my trade differ? And they're like pennies, but you can see the exact difference. And if you ever get a big difference, you can call the broker and say, hey, how come my feel was so bad here? The reason you can do that is because we trade either market on open or market on close. So let me explain this, because it's really a big deal. So a market on open order, during the night, investors go, oh, Nvidia's going up, I want to buy it. So they put an order in to buy it at the open the next day. So there are millions of these orders sitting there. And what the market maker has to do is figure out, what price can I use to get all the buyers and sellers lined up, so they all transact at the same time and they all get the same price. That's their goal. So if that open price is really rock solid. If you're day trading during the day, you're not going to get that. I mean, it depends. Is the market really volatile? Is it going up like this? Well, yeah, you're going to get a big spread. You know, the bid-ask spread is going to widen really wide. But at the open, it's like the start of the game. Boom. Now, what we have done is we have proven, in fact, I'm going to do an article on this in the blog this week, that if you can trade at the close instead of the open, you're going to make about 20% higher gains in your account. And, you know, it makes perfect sense. Why? Because we have a day where I like to pick on Nvidia, because it's just the big bad dog out there, where a stock like Nvidia goes up like this on a particular day. At the end of the day, people see that and they go, gosh, I better buy Nvidia. So they put their orders in. Well, the market maker has to move that price up, and you get a gap in your favor. So if you can get it at the close with that knowledge, you'll most usually benefit from that gap the next day going up. So it's a huge advantage. Now, here's the problem. Trading at the close is really hard to do. Why? Because you have to run your analysis beforehand. So we start our servers up. We have a whole bunch of servers. They're very fast, and they jump on that problem about 10 minutes before the exchange says we can no longer take market on close orders. Your cutoff is 10 till market close. So we time it really close. So we're analyzing, and honestly, they don't move that much anyway in 10 minutes. It's fine. It's close enough. We start that analysis, and boom, 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 we run it, and then we push the market on close orders out. If any are not executed for some reason, and things happen occasionally, you know, then they go to the open. So some orders will flow over to the open, but the most of them, I'd say 90%, go in at the close. And it, like I said, is a huge difference. I'll do this report. It'll be in the blog about the difference between market on close and market open. And it is huge. I don't know of anyone else that does that either. If you search it, like which advisor puts my positions in market on close? Crickets.
Yeah.
Doesn't have. So that's another way that we take advantage of the natural forces in the market, is market on close. And the liquidity, awesome. Your question is liquidity at same at the close, same as the open. What price? They have to do this really quick, right? So what price do I need to get so at the close I can get everybody transacted at one price? So the spread question is gone. Liquidity's not an issue. It's just one price.